Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the New Orleans State Palace Theater for tonight's main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. A lot of talk getting into tonight's matchup. Everybody expecting this to be a great night of action. Scheduled to go the full 10 if we get that far. Andre Bishop, he said to have success in this fight, I have to land combination. He landed a good one there. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Great battle, some offense of his own. See, Andre Bishop, that training really paid off. Just back to basics with the 1-2, boom, boom.
Teddy, what do you look for early on when you're analyzing a fight of two power punchers facing off against each other that gives you a clue as to which way this is going?
Who's doing the little things a little bit better? Who's using the jab? Who's controlling range? Hey, who's thinking better?
Bishop showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Halfway through round number one. Bishop's combination punching is working well here. See, that's what you want from his left hand. That's exactly what it should be doing, that left hand by Andre Bishop. Nice strike after catching one by Andre Bishop. Tremendous pace being set early on here between these two. Can't see this fight going the distance with this pace.
No, not unless something changes, like moving their heads a little bit.
Double jab, and you can see he can do it up top as well as down low. Nice work with the overhand right. Good step back. Bishop's so dangerous with that accuracy. A two-punch combination landed. Target, but way off to the side with the other. Andre Bishop's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. I like the angle that Andre Bishop just gave us right there. His opponent didn't like the result. He just ate an uppercut. Halfway through round number two. Bishop's using that jab well very early on here, Teddy. That could be a big benefit to him tonight.
Well, it's supposed to be, so he has a real good wingspan. I mean, he's got those long arms. No better way to put him to use than to use that jab and use that jab at the right distance.
Accurate hook. Good job on the two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Away those body shots with the left hand. Mike Tyson's just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. Targeting that midsection now with the combo. Really solid left hand by Andre Bishop. That's exactly what his corner wants him to do.
Let his movement on.
And round number three is underway. Little volume punching to the body there. punches together now. That's a nice combination. Getting rid of that punch from his opponent. Well blocked by Mike Tyson. Snaps that jab out. Jab right hand. Good combination punching out of him here.
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of like a musical, except right now, I don't think his opponent likes the tone of it.
To the halfway point of this third round.
Work the body, kid. Body shot. You're not focusing.
Super two-punch combo by Andre Bishop. Tyson's got it quietly. It looks like it's below the eye, on the cheek, but it's something that needs to be monitored. Andre Bishop's punch didn't come close. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. What a damaging blow. Nice hook upstairs. Bishop's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Start of round number four, a chance for us to look at Teddy's scorecard. He's trailing three rounds to zip, Teddy. People will be looking at him and say, yeah, but he's throwing punches. But Teddy, it's about throwing clean, effective punches.
Exactly. And it's about not standing in front of your opponent after you punch and waiting for the receipt.
Vicious strategy. And away he goes. And he goes down for the first time tonight. This is a tough spot for Iron Pike. He needs legs of steel. He needs a cold, steely disposition. But Iron Mike is going a little soft here after being knocked down.
Relax.
Gotta be accurate to send the combination to the body, and he does that. What an impact that left hand just made by Andre Bishop. What fighters do. Tyson's in bad shape. Solid. He goes down thanks to a swarming attack. He got caught up in a mixer plate there. Tyson's rising back up and takes some guts. Great work offensively landing that combination by Andre Bishop.
Saying, falling like a sack of potatoes.
Tyson's legs are not in good shape right now. He showed some gumption in getting up off the canvas. I don't know that he's going to last. He missed with that headshot. Bishop's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp. Landing a crisp combination.
Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. This is your night. He's closing the gap. You get close to him.
Start of the round, but Teddy, it could be the end of the fight. He's been knocked down numerous times, including the last round.
You're probably right, Joe, but when this is a darkness, it's going to find out what is special inside somebody where they can go to a place you never expect them to be able to go to. Look at Archie Moore, Yvonne Durrell, years ago. Archie Moore was over 40 years old
in there with a 20-something-year-old Durrell. He was on the floor three times in the first round. He found a way to come back and knock him out in 11. This is another one of those nights.
Mike Tyson. Unable to handle that combination. He is down on the canvas. Bishop's now a winner by knockout.
Listen, you want to win, you want to get to a title, you want to be successful, but you want to make money. And this is one way to ensure you're going to make money, scoring knockouts.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us ringside.
Good
evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore. When you get a fight like this, everybody's so interesting to see these opening moments here in round number one. Mike Tyson's blocking ability is doing well for him there. Good flush shot upstairs. He's showing what a skilled fighter he is with this counter punch. Tyson's advantage is in the speed category. He's a mover. He's an elusive target.
Well, his opponent has one advantage. One thing that can take that speed away, that is timing. You bet on this man.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Combination to the head. What should he be looking for so that he knows, hey, listen, it's time to stop this fight.
Well, first of all, he's looking at where the cut, where the blood is flowing from. It's above the eyes, so it's going down. It's impairing the vision.
Teddy Atlas. Looking forward to all the action today, and we're just about set for it. Mike Tyson's got his eye on the prize. Look at that focus and determination during his ring day.
You want to take that height away, and once you get inside, you understand there's going to be a lot of target there to take advantage of.
Right to the head with that right. Lewis is nailed by a huge uppercut. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Lewis. That right hand over the top lays flush. Off the target by Lewis. Scoring shot. It was a straight right. See that combination by Mike Tyson. Goes up top with the right hand. Brings the hook that time. Lewis is lucky he just got away with one there. He just stuck in a headbutt. That's the clean shot with the left hand that he was looking for by Lewis. Just beating the hell out of each other early on here.
Yeah, Joe, if this keeps up, they're both gonna have headaches, and we're gonna have one of the great fights to talk about.
Tyson's coming through now beautifully. That's the combination punching he wants to put forth. Very accurate with the overhand right.
Well, you're absolutely right, Joe, but I think his concern goes back a long time. The habits that he learned and didn't learn in the gym, because that's why he's getting caught with all these shots that happened in this position.
You got to breathe. You got to breathe. All right? How you feeling out there? Well, you're not winning this fight, okay? You're not.
Thank you. scheduled to go longer, but he just rescheduled it. Done. Over. Fiend. Knockout victory.
This matches up with any of the great punches throughout this sport.
I'm Joe Tessitore for Teddy Atlas saying thanks for being with us. Good evening, I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to Boardwalk Hall, the famed Atlantic City Boardwalk in southern New Jersey for tonight's main event. 10 rounds of heavyweights. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. Sat through thousands and thousands of fights together ringside, and sometimes you can tell just from the start, like a fight like this, of what you're gonna see down the road.
And what you're not gonna see. You're not gonna see a lot of guys running, you're not gonna see a lot of defense. You're gonna see two guys coming and letting it all lay out.
That was a fine block by Mike Tyson. Tyson's known as a guy who isn't going to be bashful early on. He has power, and he's not afraid to showcase it.
Yeah, but that's not all that this business is about. My mentor, Customato, used to say, hey, you know, power's just part of it. It's kind of like having a military weapon. You know, you still need a missile to get it there. Alone, all it does is make a hole in the ground. Otherwise, it has no real use. You have to have a way to get it to the target. Let's see if he has that way.
That's a good job by Bishop offensively. Landing his combinations is a key to victory tonight.
Side to side, move your head.
Able to get away from that head shot with the block.
To that, so far, so good.
Bishop's able to land at a good connect percentage. Look at the punch stats.
You know, this guy's beating shit out. You have to throw three or four punches in a row.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Right back to the work up top. There he is from long range using that jab.
So if you're on the outside, say at a picnic, you want to keep those insects away, you use insect repellent. While you're on the outside as a fighter, you want to keep your opponent away, that jab, that's the way to go.
He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Andre Bishop. Tyson with a powerful left hand. One, two jabs up top. Mike Tyson, halfway through this round here. zone. Good work by Andre Bishop. See, Andre Bishop, that training really paid off. Just back to basics with the 1-2. Boom, boom. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Well off the mark by Andre Bishop. Punches and bunches, combination up top. Tyson's able to land a good, solid left hand. The countdown, the final moments of this round. How about that left hand? There's the combo downstairs. Round comes to an end here. And Teddy, I know you've had a very busy week in training stuff with pro football players this week. There are many parallels to be made between the pro fight game and pro football.
Yeah, there are. You know, physical ones and emotional and mental ones. I mean, the physical ones are when I work with some of these behemoths, you know, like offensive linemen. They have to punch out, you know, with their arms. They have to make sure that they get those hands out now. If they raise their elbows, it's like a fighter raising his elbow before he throws a jab, they lose the power. So you got to teach them to keep those elbows in, punch out without any telegraph, without any loss of power. And also, get those hands out at the right distance. If they're a little late, the big guy gets in on him, and now he can control him. And of course, the mental aspects of it, where they get into those dark rooms we talk about every once in a while, where they have to remember that they have control. They can make the choice. You know, you get those dark rooms, you start to think that you lose control of the choice, that your opponent's making a choice for you. No, that's not the truth.
Bishop.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
He gets off with a combination up top. Teddy, a Mike Tyson left hook. Where's it come from?
Well, it comes from everywhere. I mean, he wants to make sure that he annihilates you. So he puts everything into it. Shoulder snap, body, back, everything.
Reaching the halfway mark of this round. Well, something's got to stick. He sends the combination to the body.
Stay away from those. Come on.
Get in the ring.
Bishop's jab continues to carry the day. He's wanted it, he's got it. There's the combo to the body. You see, he comes over the top with that right hand, a real solid shot.
Keep moving.
Just 10 seconds to go in this round. And this round comes to an end.
Right? You're waiting. I don't know what you're doing. Don't wait on this kid. Cook your jab in his face.
You gotta watch the water in the corner.
Andre Bishop's pitching a shutout right now on Teddy's scorecard. First three rounds all going on his side of the ledger. He's hip to the idea of becoming a counter puncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with him.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time
unload.
Him, he can counter him.
Unload, more punches.
Halfway through round number four. A snapping combination by Mike Tyson.
Yeah.
throwed away that body with the combination punching. Fires right back at him. There's the old 1-2 coming after him. Bishop's fighting real smart here on the outside. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. 10 seconds remaining in this round. And another right hand comes in.
Okay. You're doing good. Keep it up, all right?
No.
Very.
As another round gets underway, it gets us thinking, how much more of this will we see? Hard to envision this fight going the distance with how lopsided it's been.
Really frustrating his opponent now. Bishop's so defensively sound, it doesn't make for an easy target.
No, it doesn't. And it makes for a very frustrating night for his opponent. I see his opponent now, if you notice, he's getting a little tentative. He's afraid to let the punches go because when he misses, he's worried he's going to leave an opening.
A crushing two-punch combo by Andre Bishop. Good step back.
Beautiful.
Still plenty of time to work here in round number 5. Minute and a half to go. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. We overheard the corner of Andre Bishop earlier saying to look for the uppercut. That time, he found it, he saw it, he gave it. Best combination in the game, jab with the straight. Nice work by Andre Bishop. There's the hook by Andre Bishop. That is well scored. He's sending more than one at him now. The combo to the head. Bishop's doing something that not everybody appreciates, but he is making his defense a major factor.
Yeah, well, a lot of times people, you know, they only get it done on one end. What I mean about that is, you know, offensively, they use the jab, they use aggression to set up the offense, but he uses defense to set up the offense. He has a double-edged sword.
Work that body.
Oh, there's one up there, that's it.
You gotta keep.
Start of this round, start to the second half of this fight. First half of this fight, he completely dominated the action, Teddy.
Yeah, but you know what? It's kind of like they said in that movie, The Gambler, you know, they don't pay off in halftime. Remember the guy won his bet? Well, same thing. He's got another half of the fight. Can he be consistent? Can he keep his concentration? Can he keep doing what he's been doing?
Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. Bishop's showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Right back at him with a left hand. Trying to cut down that tree one shot at a time. Tyson's just rolling away, but that's not the answer at all, Teddy. These middle rounds has gone his opponent's way.
Yeah, if he had just a physical guy in front of him, so maybe it would be okay. It'd be entertaining, you know, he'd have a shot. But he has a good boxer, technician in front of him. That works.
Bishop's done a good job there, offensively scoring with that left hand. That way. after being hit himself. Well, that's yet another round.
Don't let him breathe. He's hurt. Get him this round.
What were you hearing out of his training camp as to how he got so
hurt? Search
yourself. We were hearing that he was doing his homework, wearing knapsacks with 20 pounds of sand, running uphill. I mean, that's one of them. Also, instead of taking a minute rest and sparring, he was taking 30-second rest. It's showing right now.
Keep on this guy. Keep hunting him down. Right? Cut the ring off. Move him into the room. I want him.
Back to action now. We're underway in what has been a completely one-sided fight. You get the sense this one may not go the distance. Mike Tyson digs deep with a big uppercut. Bishop's slugging style is really paying off here, Teddy. We're in the middle rounds of these fights, and it's clear to me who's controlling this.
Yeah, well, the reason it's clear to you is he's got the fight in the quarters, in the dimensions he wants it, in nice and tight.
He just missed that shot on top. A classic 1-2 combo by Andre Bishop. Tyson's crushed by a big right hand. He got rocked. He just got rocked. And he's still taking punches.
The only way right now is to grab on a little bit. Stop this throw.
Those wobbly legs of Mike Tyson have steadied.
But now the question is whether or not his opponent has found something that will work. Found something that will get those legs unsteady once again.
Good job zoning in on that body with the left hook. Even better job bringing the right hand in combination. Right to the belt line. That was a miss by Andre Bishop. Bishop's doing well sticking to a game plan on the outside.
Enough time to recover.
Tyson's combination punching is working well here. And that's the end of round 7.
It is. Keep them up, right? You're caught with your hands down. Keep them up.
As we open up round 8, we look at Teddy's scorecard, and it is much the same. All these rounds now starting to just blur together. They're taking the same exact form. One guy dominating the other.
Yeah, and the one who's dominating, why should he change? Of course he's not going to change. All the emphasis, all the burden now is on the opponent. He's got to change something.
Mike Tyson's got to be asking himself, at least his corner's got to be asking, can this go on like this? Can we continue to work at this work rate, throwing this many punches, and be this ineffective?
Joe, if he was a painter, he definitely wouldn't be referee because, you know, they're not clean strokes. They're just strokes that, you know, they look at him and they're paying off for. I mean, he's more like doing finger paints. I mean, he's just throwing stuff at that canvas, and it's not looking real pretty right now.
Boy, sharp two-punch combination by Mike Tyson. Bishop that time. There's another right hand. There's a power punch attempt by Andre Bishop, but nowhere near being a connect. Comes right back at him with a left hand. A well-targeted classic 1-2 by Andre Bishop.
Has let's understand why. He's not controlling distance. He's standing too close in front. Needs to adjust a little further out.
He missed that uppercut. So swiftly able to turn defense into offense. Nice counterpunch.
And what you're noticing here is his opponent is going to be a little wary of letting his jab go, because every time he jabs, he gets caught.
He digs in, trying to bank away body shots with the combo. Good shot to the head with that right hand. Pulls the trigger fast. Well-targeted two-punch combo by Andre Bishop. Gotta try to do better than that. He missed with that hook.
Let it go!
Iron Mike Tyson lands a big right hand. Bishop's landed a good, solid combination. Good, clean shot. Returning fire. Well done by Andre Bishop. How about a return to center with the left hand? Bishop's ability to utilize this jab, fighting on the outside. What we've seen on the scorecard so far. Why so?
Because it's not a common jab. You know, he's not the Hector Camacho, the former junior lightweight champion, because he throws a trip hammer jab. You know, usually you turn that jab over, you know, counterclockwise, but he doesn't turn it over. He just drops it down. He just drops straight down. There's no warning, and boy, it's been landed.
A solid uppercut by Andre Bishop. And now he scores well with a straight right. Tyson's productivity really dropped off tonight. And with a lack of offense, came some sloppy defense. Just look at his face now.
Yeah, you know what? He should look at his trainers too, because I always say that about this business. Where are the teachers? Where are the trainers? He should be able to get away from punches. With his experience, he should do a better job than he could do it tonight.
Looking foolish that time. He was so bad. Targeting each other, the exchange was something special. Tyson's killing me watching him here. I mean, he doesn't need a 20 by 20 ring. He could fight this thing in like a phone booth.
Now, he looks like one of those cars you see on the side of the road where they remove all the tires on the wheels. He's not going anywhere.
Through this 10th and final round. Feet. Comes right back with a shot of his own. Good, solid right hand lands.
Exactly. I mean, you're going to get a fireworks display, and you wind up getting a little bit of painting.